Okay, so ground rules. We're recording this, which is going to be on the internet, so bear in mind it's not the normal confidentiality. However, if you say something that's super revealing, like you've got a drug addiction, you don't want your boss to know, we can always wipe the recording. Okay, we have plenty of recordings, so just like if you say too much, we'll edit it out or wipe something. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Yep, cool. Also, the basic consent thing we always do, like at a certain point, I imagine we'll do some exercises, but you're in charge. So if it's something you don't want to do, like genuinely, it doesn't fucking matter just because the camera's on. I've got plenty of other examples. So for the edit, we just did consent and confidentiality, but bearing in mind it's recorded. Niger, how can I help?
So I feel confident while I am facilitating workshops, but I really want to spread out and give stuff to people online also. But every time I record something, I have like this, I feel a lot of fear, a lot of anxiety. I need...
Okay, what's going on in your voice now when you talk
yes,
about
I'm going,
it? You're like, going up? Like this?
Yes.
Like going up? Okay, so when you record, so it's, you're making some content for social media, and this is helpful for your business in terms of like promoting your work?
Yeah.
Okay, so what would you like?
Well, I would like...
take a moment.
Yes.
Feet on the ground, relax your belly. Long, take as long as you want to tell me. It's really, there's no rush. We've got actually making really good time today. What would you like?
I would like to feel ease with this, with giving my content.
Just
online.
Complete ease from day one, 100% all the time.
Yeah.
This is called sarcasm coaching. It's my specialism. Okay? So you want to have no nervousness, even though you're going to put your stuff on the internet. Everyone's going to judge you. No nervousness at all. So you basically want to be enlightened, as far as I can tell. Okay? Here's my magic wand. Boop. Okay. So what's, so I'm being sarcastic because my experience is I've been doing social media content for a long time, quite intensely, and I still feel nervous sometimes, okay? Like yesterday I did something that was a bit controversial, I still felt nervous. I was like checking it, wasn't I yesterday? Like, oh shit, okay? But it's not paralyzing me. Mm-hmm. It's not stopping me speaking my mind or promoting my business.
Mm-hmm.
So what's, like, I'd say it's unrealistic to say I never want to feel nervous ever again.
Yeah.
Particularly when you start, right? Because I've got less nervous than when I started. Mm-hmm. It took some time to develop this ease, yeah? So tell me, take another breath, laugh at yourself. We're both ridiculous, all right? That's well, that's good. You see that? Just laugh at yourself and your problems. Do that breath again, one more time. What are we letting go of there? Hands up, hands up, hands up, put your hands up, and just one, with that breath one more time, Niger. What are we letting go of now?
Fear.
Fear. Okay. Yes. Fear. Letting go of fear. What was causing the fear?
Not to be liked.
Oh, okay. So it's about not being liked. Okay. Yes. So letting go of being liked by everyone 100% all the time. Okay. Because that's impossible. Yeah. You laugh at it. Good.
No.
So there's no. It's say more. Okay. Tears coming. Okay. If your face leaks, that's okay. It's going to be okay. We have tissues. Yeah. So I have shares in waterproof eyeliner. So it's actually, I make money if you cry. Yeah. So there's something serious here as well as a joke, right? Yeah. 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 Something painful. Like, is it to be liked? To be perfect? Is it okay if I come a bit closer? I feel like I just want to give you a bit of support.
Yeah.
Like, stuff, right? So the thing you came with is about social media, but what's always behind things that are difficult is something serious, right? Hey, you with me? Hey, you went somewhere else there for a minute, huh? Yeah. All right. Face leaking thing.
Thank you.
Great. Yeah. Tell me something.
So yeah, I feel while like if I want to post something that I'm blocking myself, I can make a lot of content and then I just don't
give
do
it
anything. Yeah, it's, okay. It's like this.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. So one thing letting go of is being liked by everyone all the time. All right. Okay. You want to learn ancient Tibetan mantra? Okay. Put your hand up. Okay. Put your hands up like this. And I want you to say far.
Far.
Far. Kit.
Kit.
Fuck it. Fuck it.
Fuck it.
Fuck it. Fuck it. Now with a bit more force. Fuck it.
Fuck it.
Fuck it.
Fuck it.
Fuck it.
Fuck it.
Let's hit everyone after three. One, two, three.
Fuck it.
Okay. So one thing is literally just saying fuck it, right? Like you can't be liked by everyone all the time. It's a very natural urge. You know, we're social animals. We want to be, you know, stay in the cave, not be thrown out. One is literally just saying fuck it. And you had it in you. I didn't have to push you too hard, right? Your voice was there. Part of you wants to just say fuck it. So that's something you can do. You can just go, ah! Yeah, you could do like a forward bend. You could, you know, there's just, that's just a little tool you can take away straight away. Mm. Yeah? So a couple more tools. One is centering. You've already studied with me. So what is when you feel that like that urge, like, oh, I want to post this, but what happens? Well, do you use a phone for it? Do you, when you post, would you use a phone, mobile phone?
Yeah.
Give me a mobile phone, any phone. Just. Great. Excellent. I always have a beautiful Ukrainian social media assistant handy. So you're about to post, right? Ah, what did you just do in your throat when you grabbed the phone?
I swallowed my...
Like this, okay, anything else? What else are you doing in your body? What are you doing?
Maybe tensing my shoulders.
Maybe tensing?
Yeah.
Maybe or definitely?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, so your trapezius was tense like this, right?
Yeah.
Okay, anything else? Eyes, breath, body, anything at all?
I'm also tensing my jaw.
Okay, great. I'm going to really give you some profound coaching right now. Okay, you ready? Don't do that.
Okay.
So here's the secret, the thing, right? We have to practice.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is easier for someone to say, but now we're going to practice. Obviously now it's a safe space. Okay, so you can practice here because you're not actually posting, right? Mm-hmm. So hold the phone. Imagine you're going to post. Yeah, breathe. Feel your bum on the ground. Relax your shoulders. Relax your jaw. Say, ah.
Ah.
Think of somebody who makes you smile. Yeah. Nice. Okay. And then go blub, 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 blub. Blub, 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 blub. Okay. Good. So that's a practice you can do, right? And you can obviously do that when you're actually going to post. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So we have fuck it. We have just basic centering. This is, again, do not expect to never feel nervous ever again. It, when you're in public, putting something in public, social media is anxiety provoking, right? Yeah? Like, you don't know who's watching, blah, blah, blah. Often people, you said this before, people have this frame of putting yourself out there. This is not a good frame. That, to me, that sounds like a guy naked with his dick on the edge of a cliff in the wind. It's like, it's just too threatening. What's more positive framing for this, other than putting yourself out there? What's another way of saying this, which is less threatening?
To share something.
Beautiful, right? So sharing something. What we're really doing in any kind of marketing is looking to share something useful with someone who would like it. Right, so if I had a cake and you were hungry, would I be nervous to offer it to you? My cake, I can't tell her about my cake. Like that would be strange, right?
Yeah.
So if, the more you can say to yourself, look, I'm sharing useful things with people who'd like it. And if they don't like it, fine. They don't follow, they don't like, they don't subscribe. That's their business, right? So like, I'm just trying to be helpful. Yeah. So let's do a bit of giving pose. So this is one of the toolkit poses. Can we stand up for this?
Okay.
Might have to change the camera angle. So this is giving. Great, palms up. Feet a bit wider. I want to give you a sense of stability because the moment you're like that, if you're like that, it's a bit more stable. Yeah? So I happen to have a blanket with me. So if you were giving this to me, Craig, tell me about your social media. Some post, something you want to offer. Who's your audience here? Who's your target audience? Who looks like they might be your target audience? Yeah? Can you join us? Would you mind? You'll be on camera, but maybe you could sit down if you're willing. So, great. Is it right if I touch your back?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, offer the blanket. You're not forcing it on her. You're just offering it. If she doesn't take it, that's okay.
All right?
Wait for a moment. So back with the pose if you're happy to. Finding your center, breathing, finding your feet so you're stable. You are good whether she takes it or not. Your self-worth is not dependent upon her. Yeah? Okay, you're making an offer, extending the fingers, finding your stability. If she takes it, she doesn't take it, it's okay. Yeah? So this is a pose you can practice at home, getting into that sense of, hey, I'm giving, I'm making offers, I'm being generous, I'm offering something useful. Yeah? Thank you very much. I need my chair back. She gives you back. Okay, take a seat. Nijia, what have you learned? If you say nothing, we're going to have to get rid of the video.
No. That I'm being too harsh on myself.
Right. Okay.
With this.
You're laughing, but let's a little bit more. What are you saying to yourself that's too harsh?
That I need to be perfect.
Ah, okay. Is that true?
That I need to be perfect? Yeah. No.
Okay. All right. So just give yourself a little hug, a little bit of self-care. What can you be instead of perfect?
Myself.
Okay. And actually on social media, by far the most attractive thing is authenticity. Like, I get this feedback all the time. People are like, you know what, Mark? At least you're being yourself. You know, people really long for that. There's so much bullshit out there. Yeah? Okay. So people don't want perfect. Perfect is some Hollywood movie. No one wants that. Well. Tell yourself that. Use your first language.
I tell myself again.
Yeah, the truth. Just tell the truth.
Nija, ne rabeš biti toliko zahtevna do sebe. Ne rabeš biti popolna. Lahko pa si samo ti.
Cool. Sounds cooler in Slovenian, actually. Huh? Yeah, good. What else have you learned?
How I can use my body to support that.
Great. So let's make it real practical now. Because some of this is like psychological insights. It's interesting. Let's say you post every day. I really recommend posting like 4 or 5 days a week, you know, 6 days a week, you know, something regular. Have it in your diary. It's like 9 a.m. or 4 p.m. You can work it out. Don't just do it when you feel like it. Like mm-hmm. Have some regular schedule. If no one looks at it, no one likes it, fuck it. Who cares? You know, I make every week, I make some reels for on Thursday morning, I talk to Mirror, I make the reels, it's just a part of my week, yeah? Can you do something like that?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, some, when would be the time?
Well, I try to do it.
Try is not a word, I'm going to get Yoda on you now.
Yeah, okay. I did it this month, but I stopped.
Uh-huh. That's the past is dead. What could you realistically do that's not going to stress you too much?
Well, I just can continue with this plan. Like,
okay, so you have a plan.
Yeah.
And it's like what, 5 days a week, 4 days a week?
No, three.
Three. Yes. I recommend doing at least four,
okay.
Because then you're doing it more days on than off. Mm-hmm. So you're developing more of a habit. 4 or 5 is good, 7 is not necessary. Yeah? Okay, and is it a certain time of day?
In the morning.
In the morning, like 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock?
Yeah.
Okay, great. Like, I want it in your diary. Yeah? We're not doing fluffy embodiment coaching anymore. I'm, like, nailing you down to this commitment.
Mm-hmm.
Can be a really small thing, not a big deal. What are you going to do somatically? What are your practices are you going to do before you do the post?
Ground myself.
Mm-hmm.
Center myself.
The centering.
Breathing. Calming the...
You could do a fuck it?
Yes, fuck it, definitely. Yeah. Fuck it, definitely.
Definitely fuck it. Okay, daily practice.
Yes.
So a fuck it followed by a centering.
Yes.
And maybe this one as well. This like, because remember we're trying to brainwash you from I'm putting myself out there, which is scary, to I'm offering like in this experience, you're offering something which is helpful.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So there's three things. What are they?
Fuck it, centering, and offering.
Great. So I'd like you to write that down afterwards. This can take 1 minute. So if you tell me you haven't got time, I'll call you a liar. Mm-hmm. Yeah? Anything else on that? Anything you're worried about? Anything to make it even more practical? What about the self-care bit?
Yeah.
Something in that? Like, because it's a bit vulnerable. It is still a bit vulnerable to share, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, so maybe after the post, just take a minute to, you know, touch in like you did on the self-care, to be like, hey, I'm doing something brave. It's still a bit vulnerable. Mm-hmm. Some people might not like me. That's okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Good. Any questions before we wrap up?
No.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Voila. Good work. Hey, round of applause.